I'm Carolyn from OtoBeStamping.com, and today I'd like to show you how to make this cute little purse type card holder. I've also made some mini cards and also some envelopes using the envelope punch board to match them. So let me show you how I made this. Put these aside for the moment. And I started out with a 12 by 12 piece of designer series paper. Basically chose the black and white because I thought it was very attractive, and you get quite a few black and white in the neutrals packet, or sometimes we just have black and white designer series packets that you can purchase. This is actually from a retired pack, but I like to always use what I have, and I also recommend using what you have. So I can let you know what this one actually is, the name of this set, but I don't believe it's available any longer, so I'm just going to skip that part. So to start, I'm going to take the gift box punch board. And you'll see there's some settings here on the left, some settings here on the right, and there's also settings down here on this chart. But I'm not going to pay any attention to the charts here. I'm actually just going to go by the directions that I'm going to give you. So we're going to start out by putting our left side of our designer paper on the L4 large here on the left. And we're going to punch, and then we're going to score here. Oh, I forgot to take the arm out. Let me just do that real quick. Now, even with the arm out, this actually goes off the paper when you're scoring, so just be kind of careful and know that. And the other thing that I want to caution you on is when you're using the bone folder that actually comes with the set, it's inserted right there. You still, if you're using designer series paper, you still want to go sort of easy handed, light handed when you're scoring, because with the designer paper, it is kind of easy to score right through the paper. So you're going to see right there on the edge is where it goes off. So I've punched, I've done the, lined this up with the L, I've punched, and then I've done these two score lines. Now, I also want to do a diagonal score line, but when I do that, I'm going to slide this down to the extra large line, XL, and I'm going to line this up with the XL, and then I'm going to come down to that point that you probably can't see, but there's a point right here that the two score lines that I've already done has made, and that's where you're going to come to. It'll stop automatically anyway, because that's actually as far as your score line goes. Okay, then I'm going to turn 90 degrees. I'm going to line it up again with the L. I'm going to punch. I'm going to score on the two lines here all the way to the end. Be careful at the end. And then I'm going to scoot this down to the extra large and score straight down on the diagonal. Now, if it doesn't go all the way, which this one didn't, just stop wherever it stops. Okay, then I'm going to turn it again 90 degrees, line it up with the L, punch, score here, score here, be careful here at the end, move it down to the extra large, and do my diagonal as far as it will go, which is right there. And one last time, I'm going to move this to my paper to the L, punch, I'm going to do two score marks all the way down to there, then I'm going to move it to the extra large and do my diagonal. Okay, then I'm going to actually flip it completely over to the other side, and I'm going to line it up with the L, punch. You don't have to do any scoring on this part. Line it up with the L. Punch. Line it up with the L. Punch. And the last one, line it up with the L and punch. Okay. Now I know it's probably very hard to see any of the score lines on the video, but that's okay, because when you do this in person, you will be able to see them. So I'm just going to take, actually you might be able to see some of them, but it's not important. So then I'm just going to take my, where these are scored, and I'm gonna take my bone folder, and I'm just gonna reinforce all of the score lines. Now, in between these two punches, you're going to find your diagonal line. What I want to do is just bring that towards the center, like so. You're going to be matching these corners so that you come up with a nice 90 degree fit. Can you see that? There, that's a better view, I think. Okay, you're going to do that on each one of these corners. Bring it up, bring those two sides together. You can also use your bone folder to crease this as well. And then the other side. Crease that there. Bring these sides together. And so it's going to look like this. I can't get it all on the same camera lens, but that's okay. Then you're going to take the two side panels, whichever two you choose, and you're just going to put some snail or some type of adhesive on those and glue them down. Had to get a refill. Okay, so back to what we were doing. So just gonna press that over. And then what you wanna do is you're gonna fold these flaps in, but you wanna make sure that they are folded so that they are folded to the, let's see, I always get this mixed up, folded to that side. So the side that hasn't been glued down is the side that you want these to be attached to. Okay, so we're just going to take our adhesive and we're going to go along this line. And then we're just going to press this down. And then that's going to get attached to there. Okay, I just have to make sure I'm doing that right. Okay, then this one. Just try to make sure that you're lining that up so that it have a nice square holder. We'll go here. Together. I don't have that look quite right. Do that one a little bit. There we go. So it's best to line those up, the top there, and then kind of just come down the edge. And one more. This is going to be kind of hard to show you because now it's going to be hard to see, but again, get that top lined up and the bottom should follow in place. Okay, so right now it's going to look like this. Okay, and then you're going to want to pull this edge out slightly. I'm going to do one more thing before we move on. Now, if you use like sticky strip or tear and tape or even the multi-purpose glue, you won't need to do this step. But with the snail adhesive, it won't really hold that well. So I always like to sort of just reinforce this seam right here so that when I pull on it, which you're gonna see is the next step, it's gonna hold. Okay, so I'm just gonna hold that tight for a minute. You want to try to not get any excess glue on the outside edge here. Okay, now if you set the box upwards, it's going to look like that in the center. You want these flaps to glue down where the this flap is still up, not on the sides where the flap is glued down. So you can use any number of adhesives. You can use the Tombow glue, or you can use a glue dot, or whatever works best for you. If you use the Tombow glue, you're just gonna have to hold it for a minute, or not really a minute, but long enough for it to set. So I'm gonna put a little on the back of that one, and a little on the back of this one, and then just hold those down for a few seconds. And you can even take this and just press it down like this, but I don't really see what I'm doing. So, okay, but that's what it'll look like inside when you're done. Now, the next thing that you're going to want to do is on the flaps here, you're going to, how can I show you this? Gonna bend this over, so like about half, let's see, can you see that? So that this point meets the score line on both sides. And again, you'll attach that down. And you can't really see that, but like so. Okay, and then here on the sides where they're glued down in the inside, you're just going to gently pull on that, this is going to come together like so. Okay, so just kind of give that a little squeeze outwards. So I'm going to use Velcro dots to close this. I tried using some of these flexible magnet discs, but they were not strong enough to hold this closed. So instead, we are going to go with Velcro dots. The best way to do this is to actually put them together. You peel it off, put them on here, and then close it and press them together. Okay. Now, to decorate our box, I'm going to use this stamp set called A Whole Lot of Lovely, and this stamp, You're a Whole Lot of Lovely. I'm going to use my black Memento ink. Scrap paper. I'm just going to put that on there. Okay. Then I'm also going to use the 2 3/8 inch scallop circle punch, and I'm just going to punch. Actually, I'm going to come down here just so I know I've got enough room. Punch one of those out. Then I've given it just a minute for this Memento black ink to dry. I'm going to use my 2 inch circle punch and punch this out. Now you'll notice I'm always using the bottom of the punch so I can see exactly where I'm punching and know that if I have an image like this that I'll get it in the middle, hopefully. Okay. And then I'm just going to glue these two together. You could use dimensionals here if you wanted some space. And then I'm just going to put that together like so. And then I'm going to attach that to my box. Now, I mean, I like to think of it as a little purse. So, being that this flap goes back towards the back that way, I'm going to make this my front. Put some glue on there. And center that right there. Okay, then I'm going to add some straps. So with this one, I used paper, but then I noticed quite quickly as this was getting passed around, the paper got creased right there, and then I did not like the look of it. So you can use paper if you want, but I'm going to actually try something else. This was another one that I made, just a different shape. And actually, I'll just let you in on a little secret. If you glue the inside flaps down to the sides where you have to pull out, it doesn't work as good. It wants to come apart. So if you want to make a box like this, then it doesn't really matter where you glue those inside flaps. Okay, just a little hint. Okay, so normally I would use, or on my sample I should say, I used 2 12 by 1/2 inch strips of basic black cardstock. But with this one, I'm going to try something a bit different. So I went and looked for my ribbon stash to sort of see what I had. So I had this, which I thought would be pretty. I have just some old grosgrain black, which I think might be a little thin for this. And then I had this one, which I thought might match well because there's little dots on the, if you could see that, on the label here. And then of course this has dots on it as well. So I don't know, what do you think? This one? Or this one? And of course you can look and see what you have in your stash and then, you know, decide. Actually, I think I like the ribbon best. I'm gonna go with the ribbon. Now, the ribbon is actually gonna give you a lot floppier look. That part I probably won't like as much, but I think it'll last longer, so I'm gonna go with that. So, looking to see how much ribbon I want to use. Like I said, on the paper I used 12 inches, but I think that'll be too much for the ribbon. So I'm gonna go with about that much. So we're gonna say 10 inches. 10 inches. Don't have my ribbon cutting scissors in here. We'll just use my snips. And you're gonna need two straps. Okay. I do recommend using either sticky strip or tape and tear for this part. Being I have my sticky strip handy, I'm just gonna use that. Put it on the ends here. I like to take my bone folder and just kind of go burnish that. It helps the sticky strip to stick to the ribbon and for that top layer to peel off better. Okay, so we're gonna bring that back in, peel this off, and I'm going to put it about right there. I'm gonna bring it over. It goes on the same side. So be careful that it doesn't twist on you. I'm wondering if it wouldn't look good right on that seam. But being that I didn't do the other one that way, I'm not gonna do this one that way. But it might be a good thing to try. Okay, then I'm gonna turn it over. Oh yeah, I think that'll be a good measurement. 10 inches of ribbon, but you know, if you wanted more, obviously you could have more. I'm gonna give you just a little tip. If you've ever worked with sticky strip, you know that it likes to stick to your fingers. If you have a problem with that, just take your snail, put it on the edge of your grid paper somewhere, and then just stick it like that and it'll stay, it'll come right off your fingers, which makes it a little easier to work with. Okay, so I'm gonna put this one on here. Cute, so far so good. Oh, it's not quite the same length. I'm gonna fix that real quick. There we go. Okay, press those down real good. Okay, and then on the front of your bag, still not quite the same length. Off. Yep, okay, it's coming out pretty good. I'm just gonna make that a little bit longer. There we go. Okay, and then I'm going to use my this little flower punch comes out of one of the punch packs, but you could use anything that you have. And some scrap Whisper White. Punch two of those. And a glue dot. that right there on the end of my ribbon. Last but not least, I'm going to add a couple of jewels. Also add one to this little flower here if you wanted to. Okay, and that's the end of the project. So what do you think? Do you like the ribbon handles better or the paper handles? Like I said, I really like the paper handles. I just don't like the way they got bent so quickly. I think trying to get the cards in and out is how they got bent. So but you can then you just can open up your little purse and put your little cards in it. Now I made these cards, just in case you want to know, with the washi tape from the Playful Patterns collection, and this is from the In the Meadow set, and then the little splatter marks are, I forget where they're from, but I will definitely put that information on my blog for you. So we'll put those inside and seal it up. There you have a cute little gift idea. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, I hope you'll give me a thumbs up or leave me a comment. If you would like to subscribe to my YouTube channel, just click the subscribe button below and come visit me on my blog at otobestamping.com. Have a great rest of the day and hope to see you again soon. Thanks for stopping by.